Hello there. In this video, I'm going to show you how to use the command line tool called curl. The C stands for client, and the URL stands for a web address. So this tool is actually used for to deal with the many protocols that transfer data. The example I'm going to show is the very basic one. Getting the data from a website, from a web address, more particularly from an API web address. So I'm going to show you that on my text editor right away. Let's go and open a terminal. So curl, what you do in the terminal is I just write curl, and here for this very basic example, we put a special type of address. Addresses, that's actually the API of GitHub. It's going to happen that curl is going to fetch the users from the API. So now, it's not going to fetch all of them because it would be millions and millions. It's actually a limit here of the request to 46. But let's say that you wanted the information of one of your colleagues. All you have to do in this case is actually to put the to complete this API address with the username. I'm gonna put one of my colleagues. There you go. Instead of getting 46 different profiles, I just got the one from my colleague, Kigiri. This is the very basic use of curl. If you go into the man, you will see that there's a lot of information here, a lot of examples. You can also use Google, obviously, to understand it better. And that's it for this one. You don't need to know that much more for now. So something else I would like to show you is how to write your first shell file using this opportunity. We're just gonna go, we're gonna open my first shell file.sh. My first script. There you go. It opens the file. Shell file is always started with this bin bash. Bin bash. Bin bash, I forgot here the backslash, and that's it. A very famous one will be to echo hello world. So usually the first one that you learn, the world, save it. And if I do actually that command on the terminal, echo hello world. This happens if you use your shell. It's actually saved. It's exactly the same thing happened. And there's another way to execute the shell. This one, if the permissions are right, they're not. So in this case, you use the command chmod. Usually I do this one, 755. Change them. You will see chmod in another video. And now, there you go. You have three ways to echo hello world. Through the terminal, through your file with sh, or with the dot and the slash. Now, let's say you have several commands besides hello world. Instead of typing them all like one by one, you can actually use a shell to combine them. So that's actually what the shell is for. And for example, I'll use this command. I'm gonna copy it, paste it. Up. You can see, I'm gonna save my file. And now, if I were to execute, if I were to execute my file again, my first shell.sh, hello world, and the curl request happens as well. So there you go. You've seen the use of curl, the very basic one. You've seen a basic first shell file, which you're going to find many examples online, as well as for curl. But like I said, I repeat it for now, curl is a very basic use. The shell, you will need to use them a lot in this chapter, because this is most of the files that you will return will be shell files. So here's one of the examples that you could inspire yourself from. Thank you for your attention, and I'll see you in another video.